Henry Cavill's The Witcher Season 2 is finally out after long await. Season 1 came out Christmas 2019. It's been 2 years, and Season 2 is so much better than Season 1, and it goes so much into the mythos, some parts of the game of The Witcher 3. So let's get into it. So yo, what is good YouTube? What's you here? If you are new around it, make sure to subscribe to never miss any of the pop culture based videos. Subscribing to this channel, hitting the notification bell, helps me more than you ever know. And if you want to know what the face behind the voice looks like, just check us out on Instagram at WarStew, and also check us out on Twitter, WarStewG. So, a brief overview of Season 2. So, presumably, throughout most of the season, Geralt of Rivia was convinced that Yennefer's life was lost in the Battle of Sodden. Geralt of Rivia brings Princess Ciri, aka Cirilla, to the safest place he knows, and where he actually became a witcher. Now, I may pronounce this wrong, but don't butcher me. Kaer Morhen, which essentially is a pinnacle part to the video game. While the continent's kings, elves, humans, and demons strive for supremacy outside the walls, he must protect the girl from something far more dangerous than mysterious powers she possesses inside. So that's kind of an overview of what you should know before watching the season. Now, throughout this season, it is very cool. There's so many twists and turns throughout. So we're predominantly going to do an ending explained and break down it in chronological reverse order. So we're going to do a brief recap of everything you need to know what happens in the season predominantly. Then we're going to break down the ending and what this means and the huge, yes, the huge, there is an absolutely huge twist right at the end that most people predominantly won't see coming, because I didn't see it coming either, because I didn't even think about it. So the biggest plot points throughout these 8 episodes, we got access to episode 1-6 early. Thank you to Netflix UK for that. And I had to watch episodes 7 and 8 this morning, and hopefully this video will post by tonight. So the main vocal points, what you should know by the end of the season, is Yennefer lost her powers in the Battle of Sodden. So Yennefer, the most powerful witch mage there is, but she doesn't get her power back till the finale, is pretty cool. Jaskia, the singer, is actually in this episode and the season throughout. Ciri has elder blood inside her, and how it relates to making the Witcher mutants and new witches. And Vesemir discovers a flower that can change everything. So essentially, the theory is that she's got elder blood that can save the elves. It can help the witches mutate, although it doesn't actually happen. And at one point in this series, she's just about to have the huge witcher transfusion before Mr. Geralt stops it from happening. Now, Ciri does train to become a witcher, and she does the trial of the witcher, which if you've watched behind the scenes of the Witcher Season 2, pretty much CGI, but it really was Freya Allen taking the bumps, doing the stunts, and she did that to prove herself to the other witches, because they just see her as a little sister, aka princess, but realistically, she is defined as a princess because she is one. So throughout this, there's some pretty cool monsters throughout this in episode 3, episode 6, the finale, and the most memorable monster for me is because of that. Roach dies, but realistically, if you've watched behind the scenes, Roach is just a name that Geralt gives to all his horses, because obviously he outlives said horses. Kernoblog, I believe that's how you pronounce it. It's like this really cool, like, flying dragon-esque kind of monster that ends up killing Roach, but there's this real cool stunt scene where they bait the monster out with Ciri, and then you get Geralt of Rivia doing this crazy jump, stabs the flying monster to the death. So yeah, throughout the season, it is very good. There is far too much to break down. We're just trying to go over the main plot points. So Yennefer finds out she can get her magic back by abusing and using Cirilla. But she has second thoughts right at the end, but it's too late. And there's freaking chaos, and it nearly kills Cirilla, aka Ciri. But it was kind of obvious that it wouldn't, because she's like literally the main star. The thing with this program is it's always going to be based around Yennefer, Geralt, and Ciri throughout the whole show. Predominantly season 1, they're all loners. Season 2, they all come together. But why is Ciri so powerful? Well, she's really powerful because she's freaking OP and she has blood and she's kind of an elf, half elf-ish. So Ciri's abilities made her the target of literally everyone. Nilfgaard, But in the season two finale, we see the deathless mother of the elflish possess her in order to create chaos and unleash new monsters onto the continent. Predominantly, the princess is in possession of elder blood, meaning she's related to elves and has access to her own magic, although she isn't a magician, and we do see her teleport her and Yennefer out of trouble earlier in this season. So it is pretty interesting overall. So she essentially takes control of her body and leaving Ciri in a fantasy world where she is with her deceased family and loved ones. And this really reminded me of the Guardians of the Galaxy video game. Really did. If you played it, you know why. And she releases new monsters into the witch's home to kill the witches. Thankfully, Geralt and Yennefer are there to allow herself to become a vessel. So essentially, it goes from Ciri to Yennefer as a vessel, and Ciri is able to come free from the deathless mother's grasp and sends her back to where she came from. Essentially, Ciri does this by porting herself, Geralt and Yennefer, to another sphere where they come across the Wild Hunt, who tell Ciri to join them and name her the Stared-Eyed Daughter of Chaos, who is theirs. This is not the only time the Elder Blood came into play, as the elf queen Francesca learnt of it and told her people that Ciri's bloodline means she is the prophesied one to save the elf. And this is pretty much the ending. It's right at the end. What is the Wild Hunt? Well, the Wild Hunt first appeared earlier in the season, where they were shown briefly when Ciri was having visions whilst trying to learn about the Elder Blood. So what exactly is the Wild Hunt, you may ask? And yes, that is partially part of the video game, if you are thinking that, if you've heard of the Wild Hunt before. Well, it's a spectators that gallop across the sky and are omens of war. But if you actually look into it, they're actually Elon Eli elves, or some pronunciation of that. Pretty much their hoarder, their group's focus is predominantly on invading other worlds through the gate, other worlds to enslave, essentially. In the novel, similar to the show, the Wild Hunt becomes interested in Ciri for her powers and ancient bloodline, which everyone wants to possess. So who is the emperor? Who is the white flame? This is very interesting. I didn't see this coming. So essentially, this huge twist right at the end, Bart Edwards is in fact the White Flame, is in fact the father of Ciri, who everyone presumed was dead alongside the girl's grandmother, which we see in the fake fantasy where she was trapped. It is very interesting because I didn't see this coming at all. So the Emperor is so determined to find Ciri and were aware of her abilities before even she was, but why was he playing dead this whole time? So leading on to the next season, which has already been confirmed, presumably the Wild Hunt will be a big focus point of season 3. So predominantly, Geralt, Yennefer, are they back again together? Well, Yennefer's betrayal of Geralt predominantly told him that he couldn't trust her, but the sacrifice at the end allowed Geralt to trust her enough to train her in which abilities, as she is the strongest witch he knows, and he would need her help in protecting Ciri, because right at the end Vesemir is like, stay here, and Geralt's like, no, we need to keep moving, everyone is freaking coming. The Brotherhood has decided to put a bounty on Ciri's head. The bounty is not just on Ciri's head, but whom or whoever protects her will also have to bear the consequences. And not only that, the elves are gonna be wanting Ciri because of the Elder Blood, which can save their race. So just on that alone, there is so much going forward. And the conclusion to see that Ciri's father, the king, is alive. The ending is pure gold to go forward, because no one has a clue that Ciri's, aka Ciri's father, is alive. And I did not see that twist coming. Very fantastic. I understand that you may know more about The Witcher than me, but I really wanted to put a video out explaining everything realistically you needed to know about this season. Yennefer lost her powers in the Battle of Sodden. She gets her powers back right at the end. Predominantly, Ciri is freaking OP. Geralt of Rivia is gonna do anything to protect her. Pretty much all you need to know about the show. Bunch of new monsters in between. Roach is dead. Rest in peace. But Geralt calls every horse he gets Roach predominantly. And this did not disappoint. There were some cool battles in the Witcher homeland. The possession of Ciri, Yennefer taking control of it, sacrificing herself, getting her powers back. It was so freaking cute. There were so many twists and turns throughout this whole season. I just want to thank Netflix UK for letting me access episode 1-6 early. I really enjoyed this. Visuals, the backgrounds, although a lot of it was green screen, the magic, the CGI, Henry Cavill was spot on. CGI, countries they filmed in, locations, animations, so beautiful, very reminiscent of the video game. So like always, guys, I understand I don't usually do videos like this, but I'm gonna be doing more videos about different IPs that I'm very interested in. So hopefully you guys can support the boy. And also, if you think I explained something completely wrong, put down in the comments your ending explained. But that is pretty much the ending explained. Everything you need to know about the series, realistically, you don't need to go in massive detail. So like always, guys, check us out on Instagram at WarStew. Check us out on Twitter, WarStew G. Subscribe to the channel, please. It helps very much. And I will catch you in another video very soon. Catch you later.